is Valentine in the morning. There's $1,000 coming your way at 7 o'clock this morning. The sun's up. It's a beautiful Wednesday morning. And a first sip right after Maroon 5.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones that we love. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember, and I did not know no pain. When I believe in forever, everything will stay the same. Somebody say your name. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day, yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes. Everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything will be alright. Gonna raise a glass and say, yeah. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. And the memories bring back, memories bring back your. Memories bring back, memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember, when I never felt so lost. And I felt all the hatred, was too powerful to stop.
Six 104.3 My FM. It is Valentine in the morning. Today's first sip will take some inspiration from a TED talk, and she was talking about something, and I want to get the author right, Lakshmi Praturi. She was talking about something that was really near and dear to my heart, poo-pooed quite often on this radio show, poo-pooed quite often by many people, but as an old soul myself, or somebody that appreciates this lost art in society, I still think there's a place for it. I'm not asking people to choose between one or the other. I believe there's a place in society for what I'm about to talk about, Kev.
Yeah, let's do it. First sip is how we start the day over here. Valentine shares some inspiration, comes in many different forms. Then we all raise our cups high, our coffees, what we drink in the mornings to get us going. We have that first sip together.
The power of it. It's such a beautiful reminder of how wonderful life can be. To be able to have a connection with somebody based on what I'm about to say, that shows depth of heart, depth of meaning, that shows you took time to care about that person. What could be so powerful? What could be so amazing? The answer is so simple. And I'm not asking you to choose here, but I want you to be aware, the handwritten note, that's right. The handwritten note is a lost art that can inspire so many connections in this world. Sure, an email's fine, a text is fine. When you take the time to sit down with pen and paper, write a note to somebody, put your thoughts on that piece of paper, send that card, you're creating something tangible in somebody's hand. You're not sitting there just checking an email or whatever to their inbox or sending a text. All great, and they have their place. Don't give up. on a handwritten note. And the faces in the studio have said they've given up.
Yeah.
I can't win people over. It is so beautiful. Yeah, but it's so, so wonderful to take the time to sit down and pen something on a piece of paper for somebody. The gentleman, sadly, remember his father passed away?
Yes.
I sent him a condolence card. I think the guy was blown away. He sent us back all these wooden plaques to hang with our initials carved into them to hang in our walls. That connection was established between me and another human being, albeit a time when he's going through some tough stuff. But connections. When you send a card, many of you listening to the show, you've probably received a handwritten card from me. I send them out regularly. If you have, if you're ever listening right now and you have, text in at 31043 if you ever get a card from me personally. There's a connection there. And look at us, rocketed right up to the top of the ratings after I sent out those cards. Count us up, Jill.
1, 2, 3
Tomorrow it's the lost out of the butter churn.
Dude, you know the churn stick there, the handle? Yeah.
Yeah.
You're gonna get it.
Here's what's coming up
in Hollywood headlines.
A video of Adam Sandler is going viral on TikTok thanks to surveillance footage at an IHOP. I'll explain right after traffic. This traffic report is sponsored by Rocket Mortgage. If you're on the southbound side of the 605 coming up on Beverly and you see something going on there, let me know on the traffic tip line. Pound 250 on your cell phone, keyword SoCal traffic. Seeing heavy delays from the 10 to Beverly. Westbound side of the 60 is slowing down from Hacienda towards the 605, but haven't heard any word from CHP about anything that's in the way there. So just be prepared for something southbound side of the 605 as you're coming up on Beverly. Westbound side of the 105 freeway at Prairie, there's an accident there, taking away two middle lanes, and traffic is tough from the 710. And then, unfortunately, past that, as you're making your way up north outside of the 405, they've just canceled the signaler at Century, where all lanes there have been reopened. Traffic is heavy. As you're coming out of Torrance from about Artesia Boulevard, and that's going to stay so out towards the 10 freeway. This traffic is sponsored by Rocket Mortgage. When you're ready to buy a new home and want a mortgage lender who can help you plan with certainty, Rocket can. Need a lender who can help you understand all your mortgage options, get personalized loan options, closing costs, and tax estimates all in real time? Rocket can. Rocket Mortgage. That's your traffic. I'm Tony Jordan with Valentine in the Morning on 104.3 My FM.
Hollywood headlines.
Deadline is reporting that Fox has partnered with Warner Brothers for a sequel to The Flintstones, and the plans are to move the timeline of the show about 20 years ahead, where Fred Flintstone is near.